pressure in 2003. You remember that? That was following the Gulf War. So it was forced to shelve Project Ahmad. But it didn't shelve its nuclear ambitions. So Iran devised a plan to do two things. First, to preserve the nuclear know-how from Project Ahmad. And second, to further develop its nuclear weapons-related capabilities. That plan came directly from Iran's top leadership. Here's another document from the archive. This is following the new directive of Iran's Minister of Defense, Mr. Shamkhani. Today is the director of the National Security Council. Following the new directive of Iran's Minister of Defense, the work would be split into two parts, covert and overt.
So Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu says basically Iran is lying about what they've been doing in terms of their nuclear capabilities. He had touted this as a significant development. You'll remember that back in March of 2015, Barack Obama is still president, and before a joint session of Congress, he gave this, many people consider it, a pretty audacious speech, considering the sitting president of a key ally, and talked strongly to Congress against the Iran nuclear deal. Continuing here with what he says, Ambassador Burns, is, again, a significant development. What do you make of what you're hearing?
There's a lot to unpack here. First, if the Israelis have evidence of a program by the Iranians, they obviously ought to turn that over to the International Atomic Energy Agency and to the U.S. and to the other countries that negotiated with Iran. Secondly, no surprise that the Iranians were thinking about a nuclear weapon in the past. That's why the Bush administration and the Obama administration focused so intently on trying to deny them that. There was a strong expectation that the Iranians were trying to build a weapon. Third, this is obviously an attempt by Prime Minister Netanyahu to convince the Trump administration, and Mike Pompeo was in Jerusalem today meeting with Netanyahu, convince the Trump administration to pull out of the deal by May 12th, the Iran nuclear deal. I think we ought to stay in. All the evidence so far from the IAEA is that Iran is complying with this deal. It makes sense for the United States to stay in. Our national interests would be advanced by that. But we do have to guard against Iranian extremism in the Middle East. And over the weekend, there was an altercation between the Israelis and Iranians. I think that's the greater threat right now, the conventional possibility of a conventional threat between Israel and Iran.
Ambassador Nick Burns, always a pleasure. Thank you so much. Ann Gearin is coming back.
Thank you.
Eli Stokols, thanks to you as well. President Trump scheduled to hold a joint news conference with Nigeria's president just 15 minutes from now, actually a little less. But first, we're just days away from the start of the May midterm primary wars. Polls suggest Democrats could make major inroads. But first, they have to get through each other. We'll talk about that next.
I'm running against corporate Democrats who have all taken money, are either career politicians, lobbyists, and I'm the only progressive that's running in my race.